Hello, in this video I will show you how to set up the project drawings of this model in the page layout and how to export it to DWG, and we will do that thanks to a VisualARQ command that we can find under the VisualARQ tools. This one. In this document I already have created a page layout which has a couple of detail views, one that is showing a section, another one that is showing a floor plan. If we click inside this detail, we can see that all the elements are objects in the model. In order to export that layout to DWG, it is important that inside each detail, we are using the hidden display mode, which is a specific display mode provided by VisualARQ. Actually, in this layout, we have a third detail that I've used to show a roof plan. Also in this layout, we have some text, we have some curves and title blocks, and also some dimensions. Now, if we want to create a new layout, we can just click on this button, new layout, we define the new layout settings, and then inside this detail, we can set up a specific section or plan view. For example, we can go to the level manager that we can find already open. Actually, you can open it from the VisualARQ documentation toolbar, from this button, select the floor that we want to display, click on this button and set that floor to that viewport. This will activate the cut plane of that floor and will adjust the scale to the zoom extents of this model or to the building boundary if we had a boundary assigned. In a similar way, if we want to show a section view, we go to the section manager, can be opened from here, select the section and set that section to that view. In this case, the scale will be adjusted to the length of the section. Later on, of course, we can select the detail view, go to its properties and define here the desired scale. In this view, we can, of course, show a 3D view. We can rotate this view to show it in axonometry. And I will deactivate the section. We can also hide the specific layer on this detail and not to the others in the other layouts from the layer manager, for example, for the guides, we can hide them in this specific detail view from this column over here. It is important that inside this detail view, we are using also the hidden display mode. Now, we are ready to export these layouts to DWG. So we go to VisualARQ tools, run this command, and select the layouts that we want to export, just one or all of them. Let's give this file a name. And save it. Here we can define the DWG DXF export options, but we can leave the default ones. We click on OK. And in the command line, we can see that the file has been successfully saved. Now, let's open this file in AutoCAD. If we first check the model space, we can see that the views in each detail has been inserted spread in the model space in one-to-one scale. That means that we can edit all the lines with the true dimension. Also, the layers of the objects that each line represents have been preserved. On the other hand, the two layouts that we had in Rhino have been imported here. Just ignore these two that are created by default in AutoCAD. So let's check first the plans layout. And in this page, we have the two detail views to the model space, and also all the dimensions, text, and curves that we have originally in the Rhino layout. So this layout is ready to be printed from AutoCAD as we had it in Rhino. We can check also the other page, and we can see the 3D view we had created.